So, welcome, my friends. Hello. My name is Jason Gorenstein, and I am bringing you live streaming yoga. Today is Friday, July the 3rd, 2020, and the time is just a minute or two past 6 a.m. So, I hope you're having a wonderful morning today. Thank you, Gail, for letting me know. Special thanks to Gail for being here. Gail, I hope you're having a wonderful morning. It's so nice to see you today in practice. To Aunt Dawn, Aunt Dawn, it's so nice to see you here. I hope that you're doing well. And Madonna, Madonna, so nice to see you here. So welcome, ladies. Anybody else who's joining us, this is our daily Facebook Live yoga class, and we have a really nice vinyasa flow practice in store for us today. So let us begin our practice together. We're going to begin in child's pose and just let your breath be long and slow here. So find your way onto your mat. See that your knees are about hips width distance apart, your feet are together, and then release your arms down next to your sides, palms face the ceiling here, and close your eyes and allow your breath to become long and slow. Excellent. Okay. So as you breathe here, this is a great opportunity for us to begin to find our way into our practice and into our breath. So without further ado, guys, just begin to relax here. Close your eyes, allow your breathing to be long and slow. And just start to notice your inhalations and your exhalations. So you're in child's pose. Your knees are about hips width distance apart. Your feet are together. Your palms are facing the ceiling. Your arms are along the sides of your body. It's okay if the tailbone is lifting towards the ceiling here. It depends on our range of motion. Just want to protect those knees and the hips as well. And just begin to find your way into your breath. Excellent. So as you begin to notice your inhalations and your exhalations, just see if you can let that breath travel towards your mid-spine, lower spine region, and inhale, filling up your spine. And as you exhale, noticing any softness here, noticing any release in the shoulders, the neck region, the 8 fingers. Good. So as you inhale, filling up the breath, allowing the breath to travel in towards the low back, the middle back, the upper back. And as you exhale, noticing any softness here. So you're going to take your arms in front of you. You're going to extend your arms forward to the front of your mat. And then you're going to take your hands and you're going to walk your hands over to the right side of the mat. So walk your hands over to your right. And release the head on back down. It's okay if the hips are lifted up into the air. Breathe here. Noticing the expansion of the breath, the elongation. And then walk yourself back to center, walk yourself over to the other side, and release those hands on down. And continue to breathe into the back body, the shoulders, the hips. And as you inhale, find your way back to center. Seal the palms down. Inhale, peel the chest on up. Find your way into tabletop pose. And from tabletop pose, just begin to spread across the fingers here. So see that those palms are pressing down. Feel your outer arms hugging in and begin to lengthen through the top of your chest as you look on forward. As you exhale, round the spine and release that head on down. And as you inhale, seal the fingers down to the mat. Peel your chest on up. Breathe here as you lengthen your chest, heart, and sternum towards the front of the mat. And as you exhale, round that spine once again, release that forehead down to the mat and revolve your outer arms towards your inner arms.
And once again, inhale, peeling your chest down, forward and up. As you exhale, rounding across your spine. Inhale, taking the chest forward. This time, tuck your toes underneath you. Exhale, press your thighs back to the ceiling. Downward facing dog pose, release the head down. Soften the eyes and breathe here. So at any point, please feel free to take any breaks that you may need throughout today's practice. Remember, yoga is a practice of listening to our bodies. So if at any point you need to rest or relax, please feel free to do so. Walk the hands back towards your feet and find your way into a nice forward fold here. Release the head on down, close the eyes, and breathe. So now, take your arms, interlace your thumbs to your elbows, and just release the head on down once again. Just drift the elbows over towards your left leg, and back to center, and drift the elbows over towards your right leg, and back to center. Now take your hands to the low back, press down through the feet, inhale, lift the chest, and find your way to standing. Release the hands down the flesh of the buttocks, and take the palms to face the front of the room. So see that those fingers are spread wide apart. Allow the eyes to be soft here. Allow the breath to be long and slow. On an inhale, raise your arms up towards the ceiling. And as you exhale, release your torso all the way down to the mat. Good. Take your hands to your shins. Inhale, lengthen your chest, your heart, your sternum. And as you exhale, hinge on forward, release those hands back down to the mat. As you inhale, float those arms up towards the ceiling, raising up through the fingers. And as you exhale, gliding those fingers next to the sides of the body and allowing that chest to remain lifted. Inhale again, raise the arms up and above your head. This time, interlace your fingers up above your head and press the palms up towards the ceiling. You're gonna take a nice long stretch along the left side of the body as you take the hands over to the right side, breathing in. Inhale, coming back to center. Exhale, finding your way to the other side. Keep lifting that chest and heart. Inhale, back to center. Look up towards those hands, and on an exhale, hinge on forward, release the hands down to the mat. Now take your hands to the shins once again. Inhale, peeling the chest forward and up. And as you exhale, you're going to plant the hands down to the mat and walk the feet back, downward facing dog pose. Be here for a moment. Spread across your fingers, lift your inner forearms up towards the ceiling, drive your outer thighs back to the back of the mat. Good. And on the next breath, you're going to lower the knees down to your mat. And you're gonna step your right foot in between your hands. So maybe see that you have blocks on either side of your right foot. As you take the right foot forward, untuck the left toes so the left back of the foot's pressing down to the mat. You can walk the blocks back and inhale, peel up the chest here. Take your right hand, place it on top of your right thigh. Lift your chest up even higher. And on an inhalation, raise the left arm up towards the ceiling. As you exhale, float that left arm down to the mat. As you inhale, raise the left arm up towards the ceiling. As you exhale, float the left hand down to the mat. One more time. Inhale, float the left arm up towards the ceiling. This time, glide the right arm up to follow. See that you're pressing down through the left shin. See that you're pressing down through the right foot. On an exhalation, take the hands back down to the mat. Step your right leg back to meet the left leg. Find your way back in a downward facing dog pose. Downward facing dog pose, walk the feet a little bit wider apart. See that you're lengthening through your heels. See that you're lengthening through your fingers here. And then as you feel ready, you're going to walk the feet forward once again to the top of the mat. As you inhale, bring your hands to your shins. And on an exhale, release those hands all the way down. Inhale, raise the arms up towards the ceiling, lengthen across the fingers here. And on an exhale, glide your arms back down to your sides. So press down through the feet. See that the outer thighs revolve towards the inner thighs. See that chest lifts up towards the ceiling here. Inhale, float the arms up towards the ceiling, palms touch. Exhale, hinge at the hips and fold all the way down to the mat. As you inhale, lift the chest up halfway. One more time, take those hands down to the mat. Walk the feet back in the downward facing dog pose. So downward facing dog pose, lower your knees down to the mat. Take your blocks, place your blocks back on the mat and step your left foot forward this time in between your hands. Now as you press down through the fingers, walk the fingers back, walk the blocks back and inhale, come high up onto that left knee. So you're lifting up the chest pretty high. Now take your left hand, place it on your left thigh. Inhale, float your right arm up above your head. And as you exhale, glide that right palm all the way down. Two more times. Inhale, floating that right palm up. So press down to the left foot as you do so. As you exhale, drive that right palm on down one more time. Inhale, glide that arm up above the head. This time, allow the left arm to float up as well. As you take both arms up, can you draw the belly back towards the back of the spine? As you exhale, release the hands down to the mat. Step your left foot back behind you. Again, find your way into downward facing dog pose. So downward facing dog pose once again, spreading across the fingers here, releasing the head down in between the arms, and breathing here as you extend the legs back to the back of the room. Now walk the feet forward to the front of the mat, and as you inhale here, lengthen the chest, heart, and sternum halfway up. On an exhale, hinge and fold here. Raise the arms up towards the ceiling, lengthen across the fingers here. And as you exhale, glide the arms back down to the sides and lift the center chest on up. Again, inhale, float your arms up towards the ceiling, palms touch. As you exhale, hinge on forward and release the fingers to the floor. Take your hands to the shins, inhale, lift the chest on up. And walk the feet back as you find your way into downward facing dog pose. Downward facing dog pose, release the knees down to the mat and lower the chest all the way down to the mat as you bring your hands along the sides of the body.
So see that your forehead is touching along the floor. Take your fingers, lift your fingers, extend
along the sides of your body. As you inhale here, peel up your chest, your heart, your sternum, and press down through the tops of your feet and the tops of your fingers. So see that your chest is peeling on up. As you exhale, lower that head on down.
We're going to do that again. So as you inhale, peel the chest on up.
This time, can you turn your thumbs to face the floor? Turn the pinkies to face the ceiling. Maybe see if you can float the right leg up. Lengthen through the chest. On an exhale, lower the right leg down.
Lower the head on down. Lower the palms. As you inhale, turn the pinkies to the ceiling.
Press down through the right foot, float the left leg up. Lift through the chest, lift through the heart, lift through the sternum. On an exhale, lower on down once again.
All right, one more time.
Inhale, lift the chest up, float the fingers up, and then this time float both feet up. So your toes are just hovering off the mat. They're not very high. And you turn your pinky fingers or your pinky toes down to face the floor. So your pinky toes are facing down. Your big toes are facing up and you're breathing here. On an exhale, take the hands underneath the chest. Press the palms down to the mat. Inhale, lifting the chest on up. Exhale, pressing on back, downward facing dog pose. Good. So downward facing dog pose, we're gonna step the right foot in between the hands. So if you'd like, you can lower the left knee to do so in the first round, and then step that right foot forward in between the hands once again. Now press down through the left toes. You may want to use blocks on either side of the right foot. As you inhale, lift that left leg on up and extend through the center chest. So press down through the right foot. See that that left heel is pressing back. See that that chest is lengthening on forward. Now spin your left heel down to the mat. Walk your right toes so that your right heel is in line with the left arch of the foot. And then from here, take your left hand to the left hip, take your right hand to the right hip, and then straighten across that right leg. Now look at your right foot. See that your right foot is parallel with the inner edges of the mat. And as you bend into that right knee, see if you could sink a little bit deeper into those legs. So the right knee bends to 90 degrees and your chest is lifting here. As you straighten across that right leg, lift the chest even higher. So on an exhale, we bend into that right knee, place the right palm on the right thigh. And then as you inhale, straighten across that right leg and bring the right hand to the right hip. One more time. So bend that knee, right hand comes to the right thigh. So you're pressing that thigh down as you're lifting the right outer hip up. And then as you exhale, extend the arms all the way out to the sides. Now straighten that leg one more time. Take the hands, float them to the hips. Re-bend into that right knee and take your hands back to your blocks. So spin onto the ball of your left foot, walk your right toes over to the right. And as you exhale, lower that left knee down and begin to straighten across your right leg. So you release the head down for a moment here as you come into this long hamstring pose. Breathe here as you continue to lengthen the chest, heart, and sternum. Nice, and as you feel ready, step the right leg back to meet the left at the back of your mat. So you can lower the blocks down onto your sides and press back into downward facing dog pose. So downward facing dog pose, being here for a moment, just releasing that head all the way down. And you can shake the head right and left, and you can shake the head up and down. And as you feel ready, step the left foot in between your hands this time. So you can lower that right knee down, or you can just step the left foot forward. Now take your hands to your blocks, if you'd like, and then press down through your fingers. See that you lift up that right leg and press the right heel back to the back of the room. So that right leg is lifting up and the left knee is bending here. Walk the left toes to the center of the mat, spin the right heel down. As you spin the right heel down, lift the chest, lift the heart, lift the sternum. And then from here, float both hands onto your hips. I'm just switching sides. Float both hands onto your hips and lift the chest on up. So now, we're just gonna begin to work that left front leg this time. So you bend into that left knee and you press your left hand down into that left thigh. On an inhale, straighten that leg and bring your hands back to your hips. On an exhale, bend into that knee and press deeply into that thigh. As you inhale, straighten across that leg and bring your hands back to your hips. One more time, bending that knee, placing that hand on the thigh, and this time taking your arms out to your sides. Reaching across your fingers here, lengthening across your chest, your heart, your sternum, and we're in Warrior Two pose. So Warrior Two pose, let's take our hands to the hips and straighten one more time. And as you exhale, bend that knee and place your hands on the blocks. Spin onto the ball of your right foot, walk your left toes over to the left, release that right knee down and begin to straighten across the left leg. So we straighten across the left leg to work the outer left hip flexor, the left hamstring, and the left glutes. And breathe here. And as you feel ready, step that left leg back to meet the right at the back of your mat. Find your way into downward facing dog pose. So from downward facing dog, let's walk the feet forward to the hands. And let's walk the hands back to the feet as we lift the chest up halfway. On an exhale, hinge at those hips and fold all the way down. Now take your hands to the low back, press through the feet, inhale, lift the chest on up. Smooth the flesh of the buttocks away from you, open the palms, lift the chest. Take your hands, bring them to your hips, bend deeply into your left knee and spin your left heel to touch your right ankle. Take the hands to the center chest here. This is called tree pose, Vrikshasana. Inhale, raise the arms up and out to the sides of the body. So continue to breathe here as you lift the chest. If you want a little bit more, maybe float that left foot off the floor and place it on the right calf. Breathe here as you draw both outer thighs in towards one another. On an exhalation, bring the hands back to the center and release that foot on down. Hands come back to the hips again, just to center your body here. And then as you feel ready, we bend the right knee and take the other side of the pose. So guys, take your time here, no rush. We're building the postures out the proper way. So just be wherever is comfortable for you today. Obviously, you could always watch the video again. You could go deeper. But really just be with your body today, because you don't want to overly push yourself, especially in yoga class. Inhale, raise the arms up above the head and breathe. And then if you'd like, you may float that right foot off the floor. So this is only if you feel very strong in your balance in that left leg and you feel a stability here as you lift those arms up and above your head. And on an exhale, release that right foot down and take the hands back into center. Hands come to the hips. We're going to step the feet wide apart this time. So step your feet wide apart in either direction. And as you feel ready, hands come to the buttocks, lower yourself all the way down to the mat. This is called Prasarita Padottanasana. Release your head down. See that your heels are pressing out from your inner foot to the outer foot. See that your toes are pressing out from the inner foot to the outer foot. So you guys should feel like the legs are becoming a little bit longer in this pose, in this Prasarita Padottanasana pose. Now take the hands to the hips, press down through the feet, inhale, lift the chest on up. Spin your feet over to the right side of the room. Take your arms out to the sides. Hinge at that right hip and release the right hand down the right leg. Lift the left arm up towards the ceiling. So press down through both feet here, firm the right buttocks underneath the body and lift up through those left fingers. If you feel like too much weight is in the right heel, bend the right knee. See that the weight shifts forward to the right big toe mound of the foot and allow for the chest to keep lifting up as you turn the left hip down to the floor. That's a really important action. When that left hip turns down, you are protecting your hips, but you're also using more of your thoracic chest to twist. Inhale, lifting that left hand back up, taking your hands back to your hips. Let's turn our feet back to center. So be here for a moment. This is called Prasarita Padottanasana. And as you feel ready, turn your right foot in, turn the left foot out, and we're gonna take the other side of the pose. Left hand glides down the leg, right arm glides up towards the ceiling. So lift up through that right arm and bend deeply into that left knee. The left knee bends here, press through the right heel, press through the right ball of the foot, and inhale, lift up through the right side of the chest. Breathe here as you lengthen. See that the toes are spread wide apart, and see that your breath continues to move naturally here in this pose. And as you feel ready, once again, inhale, float that right arm up above the head, hands come to the hips, turn your left foot in, and step your feet back together. So once again here, we're in Tadasana pose. So we take Tadasana pose, this standing mountain pose it's called. And then what I'm gonna have you guys do is take your arms and hug across your shoulders. So take your right hand above your left and your left hand below your right, and just release here for a moment. This is actually a prep pose, is spreading across our shoulders. And then you're gonna take your hands once again, bring your arms out, and you're gonna glide your hands back the other way. So now your right hand is underneath your left and your left elbow is above your right. So this is a stretch sometimes we take to spread the shoulders wide apart. And then take your hands to your hips once again and step your feet wide apart, spin both feet over to the right side of the mat and bend deeply into that right knee. So one more time, right knee bends deeply here. You place your right hand on your right thigh. And as you feel ready, lower your right forearm down to the right thigh crease. Left hand's on the left hip. Breathe here as you press into that left outer foot. Revolve your chest up towards the ceiling. And on an in-breath, lift your left arm all the way up towards the ceiling. So that right knee bends to 90 degrees. The left arm's extending up towards the ceiling. Now, take your left hand, bring your left hand forward and lift your left arm up above your head. So guys, remember the very first pose we started with, that lunge pose? What did we do? We did this three times. The arm came back and up, and the arm came up and over the head. The arm came back and up, and the arm came up over the head. So this is actually using our core strength. Once again, the arm came back and up, and the arm came over the head. And keep extending as you bend deeper into that right knee, Press through those toes, lift through the chest, and breathe. Inhale, lift that left arm up. Raise yourself out of the pose. Straighten across that right leg and turn your feet in. Spin your feet over to the other side. Bend deeply into that left knee this time. And place your left forearm on top of the left thigh as you continue to breathe here. So you take a moment here. This is really the setup of the pose. This is the first part of the pose. And then as you feel ready, lift the right arm up towards the ceiling. It's called extended side angle because we make an angle with our left knee and we extend across the right side of the body. We take our right hand, we lengthen it forward and up, and we raise that arm up and over the head. So we do this a few times for a couple of reasons. Number one, to loosen up the shoulder girdle region. So it helps us to protect our shoulders and it helps us to bring some flexibility into the shoulders. Secondly, we do this in order for us to maintain a length in the body. So the arm extends forward and up, and you lengthen that arm all the way over. And then again, the arm comes all the way up and lengthen that arm up towards the ceiling. One more time. Arm comes forward and up and lengthen that arm up over the head. Arm comes forward and back and lift that arm up towards the ceiling. Lift that right arm up, hands come to the hips and straighten across that left leg. Again, turn the feet into center and forward fold here. So as you forward fold, take your hands, bring them to your mat, and this time just walk your hands back a little bit more. So maybe your fingers walk back towards your heels and release that head all the way down to the floor. Stretch out the backs of the legs here. It's okay to add a light bend in the knees as well. And just breathe into the back of the body. Remember, there may be ranges that you can move into. So breathe into that part of the body, wherever it feels comfortable for you, and release here. Take the hands, walk the fingers forward, place the hands back on the hips, step your feet back together once again. On an inhale, open up the chest and the heart and raise through the center chest. So this is our mountain pose once again as we continue to breathe here. Inhale, float those arms up and above your head. And as you exhale, hinge at the hips and fold all the way forward. Inhale, lengthening the chest. Step the feet back, walk back, downward facing dog pose. Downward facing dog pose, lower the knees down to the mat. Lengthen your right leg back to the back of the room. As you lengthen that right leg back, spread across the fingers here. See that you're pressing back across that right heel. Then lift that right leg up above your, or back behind you, and lift the chest here. On an exhalation, you're going to draw the right knee into the chest. As you inhale, you're going to extend back all the way through that right leg. So this is a gluteus muscle workout. Right knee comes into the chest, round the spine here. Inhale, lifting that right leg up and back behind you. One more time. Right knee comes to the chest, round the spine. Inhale, float that right leg up. And this time, take the left arm forward. So spin the left outer arm in, hug that belly in, and breathe here. On an exhale, lower the left hand down, lower the right knee down. So take the left leg back, press back through the left ball of the foot. And as you revolve the outer arms in, breathe and lift that left leg on up. So once we lift that left leg up, we're engaging the core, we're engaging the thighs. And then on an exhale, you're gonna draw that left knee in towards the center chest. As you inhale, float that left leg up and back behind you once again. And as you exhale, rounding through the spine and hugging the knee into the chest. One more time, sending that left leg back and behind. This time, as you balance between your left hand and your right knee, maybe extending your right arm forward in front of you. So this is a variation of the pose. Release that right palm down, release the left knee down. Find your way back into child's pose. So once again, child's pose, you can always keep those hips lifted and release the head down to the mat. So this is a variation of child's pose, or you could release the hips all the way down to the heels in our classical child's pose. And as you inhale, you're gonna lift on up. You're gonna interlace your fingers here and walk the knees back. And you're going to exhale, lower down the pelvis all the way onto the mat. So see that your fingers are interlaced. See that you're pressing down through your wrists, fingers, and your forearms. And continue to lengthen up through the center chest. So draw those shoulder blades back and down the spine. Hug the belly in. One more time, inhale as you press down through the left leg. Can you lift the right leg up off the floor? Nice, as you exhale, lower that right foot on down. So as you press down through the right foot this time, can you inhale, lift the left leg up off the floor? So drive the left leg in the center and firm the belly in. As you exhale, lower that left foot on down. Excellent, guys. All right, so from here, tuck the toes underneath. Press down through the wrist, forearm, and the fingers. And as you inhale, lift the belly off the floor and then look down towards the floor. So you're still on your knees, you're still on your toes, and you're breathing here. On an exhale, lower that belly all the way down to the floor. So these are kind of reverse crunch workout. So as you press down through your fingers, wrists, and forearms, you inhale, lift the belly up. You compress the belly, you coil that belly in, and you look down towards the floor. On an exhale, you lower that pelvis down and you release the belly again to the floor. One more time. So inhale, coil on up. Lift the belly off the floor. Keep pressing those forearms down. Keep pressing those knees down and breathing here as you pull in that belly. Nice. And then as you exhale, press your hands down. Find your way back to table and eventually pressing on back to downward facing dog pose. Downward facing dog pose. Once again, step the right foot in between the hands. You can always lower the left knee down to do so and spin the left heel out. As you press down through your right foot, take your hands to your hips. See that your right foot is in line with your right heel. So you're going to walk your right toes over a little bit so that you have a little wider stance in your legs. And keep those hands on the hips here as you breathe. Now, the left hip turns forward to the front of the mat, the right hip draws on back. And as you bend deeply into that right knee, you're gonna inhale, float the left arm up towards the ceiling. And as you exhale, straighten that right leg and bring the left hand on down. So right hand stays at the hip the entire time. Bend that right knee. Inhale, float the left arm up towards the ceiling. Straighten that left leg and straighten the left arm back down. One more time. Bend the right knee. Float the left arm up towards the ceiling. This time, float the right hand up as well and breathe here for a moment. This is called Warrior One. See that you're pressing through your left foot. See that you're lifting through both sides of the chest and breathe here. Maybe even as you look towards the fingers up above your head. As you exhale, straighten that right leg and take the hands back to the hips this time. And on an exhale, hinge on forward and release the hands down to the mat. So what I would do here is maybe take your blocks and place them on either side of the leg. If you don't have blocks, one option that you have is to re-lower that right knee down to the mat. So you could either lower that right knee down, or if you have blocks, you could lengthen across the body here. So reach the chest forward, firm the navel in. There can be a light bend in that right knee is fine, and continue to lengthen the left hip forward as you drive the right hip back. And breathe here into this extension, side, stretch. Nice. Now, bend that right knee, lower the left knee down to the mat, and you're gonna step the right foot back and behind you as you float the legs back one more time into downward facing dog pose. So downward facing dog toes, make sure that the feet are pretty wide apart. So if the feet are too close together, you don't get that extension along the backs of the legs. And as you feel ready here, actually, let's move on an intermission before we move forward. Shift forward into plank pose, lower the knees down, and lower the chest all the way down to the mat. All right, so take your hands, bring your hands behind your back and interlace your fingers here. And as you interlace the fingers, see that the fingers lengthen towards the backs of the knees. And on an inhale, lift the chest on up and peel your heart towards the ceiling. It's okay to keep your hands on the buttocks. See if you can float that right leg up. And on an exhale, lower that right foot down. And on an inhale, float the left leg up. And on an exhale, float that leg down and release the head on down. So breathe here for a moment. Just release that head down. Good, and we're gonna move into that once again here. So once again, lifting up, interlace the fingers once again, opposite way this time, and begin to peel the chest on up, begin to lift the heart on up. So now drag the fingers back behind the buttocks, flesh, and as you press down to the right foot, inhale, lift the left leg up. And then lower that left foot down, and as you press down to the left foot, inhale, lift the right leg up. And lower that foot on down. Take the hands, release them, bring the hands to the center chest, lower the forehead down. And as you press down through the hands, lift the chest on up and press your way back into your downward facing dog. So downward facing dog once again. Once again, feet have to be at least hips width distance apart. It actually protects the legs to keep your feet a little bit wider apart. Now you can either step the left foot in between the hands or you can lower your knees down and step that left foot forward. I'm just coming to the other side of the mat to show you guys. So you're gonna press down through the left foot, you're gonna press down through the right, spin that right heel down, walk the left toes over so that the left foot is in line with the left hip, the right foot is in line with the right hip. As you take the hands to the hips, inhale, lift the chest, and find your way to standing. Keep your left hand at your left hip, keep your right hand at your right, and bend deeply into that left knee once again. All right, now take your right hand this time. Right hand extends all the way up towards the ceiling. And as you straighten across that arm, straighten the leg as well. So bend deeply into that left knee. Inhale, float your right arm up towards the ceiling. And as you bring that right hand down, straighten across your left leg. Inhale, float the right arm up. Raise your right arm to the ceiling. Okay, this time, as you float your right hand up, float the left hand up as well. Bend deeply into that left knee and maybe look up towards the fingers as you bring the fingers up to touch. Good, and as you exhale here, straighten across that left leg and bring the hands to the hips. So now we're gonna come into a long stretch across the left side of the body. You begin to lean forward, take the hands to blocks, and release the head on down. Now if you don't have blocks, you could consider lowering that right knee down to the mat and breathing here into our Parsvottanasana stretch. So you can always lower that right knee down and release the head down as well. So this is a great stretch to take. It's often called runner's stretch. I don't know if you ever heard the runner's stretch. This is runner's stretch. And breathe here. Excellent. And then from here, you're gonna lift up the chest, lift up the heart, lift up the sternum. One more time, let's turn our feet back to center. And on an exhalation, let's release our hands all the way down the legs and to the floor. Now, take the hands to the floor, walk the hands on back, and see that you can continue to release that head on down. Wrap your outer arms in, firm the belly in here. And then as you walk the fingers forward, you'll take your left hand to center and the right hand to the right hip. Now draw the right hip into the left and begin to revolve your chest up towards the ceiling. And breathe here as you spin the chest any amount from the ground towards the ceiling. Good, and as you exhale, lower that right palm down back to the mat. Now take the left hand to the left hip and begin to revolve the left chest up towards the ceiling here. Lift the chest, lift the left chest up, lift the sternum up, and breathe here. And as you exhale, lower that left hand back down to the mat. Release the head on down, breathe here as you release the head all the way down. Now take your hands, bring them onto your shins, and breathe here. Should be a long stretch in the backs of the legs. You're just gonna release the head down to the mat, breathe into the backs of the legs, and I suggest that you bring a light bend into those knees as well. When the knees are bent here, it just protects the knees and it actually protects the backs of the legs as well. Just bending the knees, even if it's just a couple of millimeters, is a good stretch for the body. Now take the hands to the hips or to the floor once again. Place your hands on your hips. Inhale, step your feet back together as you come to standing pose. Turn the palms to face the front of the room and lift your chest all the way up. All right. Take your hands to your hips, bend your knees. And as you bend your knees, inhale, float your arms up to Utkatasana pose. So I have a very mild bend in my knees, as you can tell. My knees are not bent a lot, but you can still feel this stretch. You can still feel the stretching across the abdomen, the stretching across the legs. Straighten those legs and release those arms out to the sides. Okay, take the hands to the hips one more time. You're gonna bend the left knee and you're gonna turn the left foot out to the left side of the room. One more time, bring those hands into the center chest and breathe here. Now, take the hands to the hips, interlace the fingers back behind you, lift the chest on up. And on an exhale, this is kind of a difficult pose. You're gonna lean forward here and lift those arms up towards the ceiling. So you have a kickstand in those legs, you're drawing the belly on in, and you're releasing the trunk of the body all the way down to the mat. Inhale, lifting the chest on up, and come back to standing. There's no formal name for this pose, I kind of just created it, but it's a pose, like, you could combine poses together and make new poses all the time. Release the left foot down. Right knee comes into center, and then turn the right heel back into center, good. So interlace the fingers behind the back, draw the right heel into the left ankle, hinge the waist forward, and inhale, lift those arms on up. So once again here, as you bend and lean on forward, this is just, it's a nice balancing stretch. It is a difficult stretch as well, but it's good for the body, kind of to challenge it a little bit. And then come back on up, release the feet, come down. Interlace the fingers at the center chest, press the palms forward, and raise the arms up towards the ceiling. One more time, glide the fingers over to your right, and exhale back to center. One more time, glide the fingers over to your left, and exhale back to center. Okay, so from here, you're gonna take the hands to the hips one more time, and you're gonna step the feet wide apart. So one more time, we step the feet wide apart, and one more time, you're going to turn the feet over to the right side of the room. So turn the feet over to the right, step your feet wide apart so you have plenty of space here. You're gonna take your right hand to the outer right hip, you're gonna inhale, lift your left arm up towards the ceiling. As you bend into that right knee, you're gonna lift that left arm up even higher, and then you're gonna reach the arm forward and place that left hand down on the floor. You could place it on a block if you'd like. Now stay here for a moment. You could stay in this pose if you'd like, or take the right hand, place it on top of the right thigh, and maybe begin to look up towards the ceiling. So this is a somewhat twisting pose, so if you're against twists, if you're not doing twists today, just look down to the floor. You could be here and still get the strength of this stretch. If you're working the twist, just turn your right head over the shoulder. Both options are perfect for today. Breathe. Good, and as you inhale, lift on up. Take the hands back to the hips. Turn the feet back into center. Turn the feet over to the other side. So as you turn the feet over to the other side, right hand comes to the right hip. Bend deeply into the left knee. Good, as you breathe here. And inhale, raise your right arm up above your head, draw the left hip on back, and glide the right hand forward, and release it down to the floor. So you could just stay here, you could also place your right hand on a block here, this is perfectly fine, and then some of us are gonna twist while others of us are just gonna hold the pose. This is a strengthening pose to the body, requires a lot of the strength that we've built throughout today's practice, and even if you're not twisting, you're still getting a lot of the benefits of this pose. If you decided to twist here, you're gonna inhale, lift on up, and otherwise you're gonna lift on up and come back to center. Step the feet towards one another, take the palms out to the sides, inhale, interlace the fingers of the center chest and float the palms up towards the ceiling. And as you exhale here, release the hands back down into your sides. Beautiful, guys, okay. So we're ready for our ground practice right now. We're gonna start with downward facing dog. So as you feel ready, lower your weight onto your knees, spread across the fingers here. See that the palms are under the shoulders or slightly forward of the shoulders. See that the knees are in line with the hips, knees are in line with the feet. Tuck the toes underneath, lift the thighs on up. Downward facing dog pose. Breathe here. So from downward facing dog pose, just breathing here for another moment. Spreading across the fingers, wrapping your outer arms in, and breathing here as you lengthen your hips back to the back of the room. Lower those knees down to your mat. You're going to spin those legs on forward here. And you're going to take your legs forward in front of you as you come into a seated pose. Okay. So on our seat, what I'm going to have you guys do is I'm going to have you guys extend your legs forward. And if you have a blanket to sit on, that helps. Just because the hips, when they're lifted, it's a little bit easier for the body. And then from here, what I'd like you to do is bend the right knee into the chest. You're going to take your right forearm around the right knee and turn away from that knee. So the turn is not going to be that much. You're just opening up the chest and the heart here. We also take this stretch because it works the outer right hip socket. It works the outer right leg as well. And breathe in. And then take the right leg forward and draw the left knee to a bent position. Grab the left arm around the left leg and bring the right hand back behind you. And twist here once again. Back to center. Bring the feet together, bring the knees apart. I'd actually recommend placing blocks underneath the knees if you have a couple of blocks. And this is called Baddha Konasana pose. It's called Cobbler's pose. And it's a great pose for the inner legs. You don't even have to fold that much forward. You can start by lifting the chest on up. And then you hinge at the hips and you begin to lean the chest up forward. So however far forward you lean is fine. You're gonna close the eyes here and breathe into the chest, the heart, and the belly. So, this point of our class, we begin to slow down. We begin to slow down. As you feel ready here, you're going to take the legs and extend the legs out to your sides. So just like this, legs extend out to the sides and breathe here. So this is called Upavishta Konasana, just means wide angle. Upa means upward facing, kon means angle. It's a wide angle pose. So Upavishta Konasana, and you take your right hand in front of you and you take your left hand over to the left, or behind you rather, and you just lift the chest up here. So you're lengthening across the entire right side of the body as you turn slightly towards the left. So it's a very mild stretch, but we're still getting an activation of this inner right groin all the way to the inner right knee. And then come back to center. Take your left hand forward in front of you and take your right hand back behind you. Upavishta Konasana to the other side. And then from Upavishta Konasana, you're gonna take your hands and hold onto your shins. Flex both feet here and begin to lean on forward. As you lean on forward, lift the chest on up and breathe here. breathe as you lengthen through your chest, your heart, your spine. All right, come back up. So now, as you feel ready, let's take our legs and let's bring them back together. We're gonna come into one forward fold here. So you'll take your legs forward in front of you, and you're just gonna stretch your hands towards your feet as you release the head on down. However far forward your hands get is fine. Please don't worry about grabbing hold of your feet. An option if you'd like to here is if you have a strap, you could place a strap around your feet. And this is what usually we teach students to maintain length in their body. So having that strap here is a really nice way to kind of create that length, but not to compromise the back or the shoulders here as you close the eyes. This is called Paschimo Uttanasana, which means west facing east. Paschimo Uttanasana. West, east, both. Pashi is west, or downward facing. Mot is east. Upward facing. All right, and then as you feel ready, we're gonna come onto our back. So as we come onto our back, we'll tug our knees into our chest and breathe here. This is called Balasana, or ball pose. As you take Balasana, be here for a moment, just breathe. Now draw the right knee in as you lower the left foot down to the mat, and just hug in here as you breathe. This is really to kind of close down the stretches. And then you'll take your left knee into the chest as you release the right foot on down. Good, and then as you feel ready here, release both feet on down. Now, take your right foot, release it out. Take your left foot, release it out. Turn your palms to face the ceiling as you draw your shoulders underneath you. See that the chest lifts on up. See that the shoulder blades move in and under the spine as you breathe in. And release. Now take your elbows up, to a bent position for a moment, and just roll your knees over to the left and breathe here for a few. And do the same to the other side. Good, one more time, just extend your legs fully forward in front of you. That's just to kind of release the rest of the back and take your palms out to the sides. We'll just be here for a minute or so. This is called Shavasana. So now, point your toes forward
and take your arms up and over your head. Stretch your arms all the way back. And then bend your knees and roll your knees onto your side.
As you press down through your palm, inhale, lift the chest on up and find your way back into a seated position, cross-legged. So now take the hands to the center chest, and as we exhale, we release the head down. Inhale, lift the head, open the eyes, namaste. All right, so thank you guys. I hope you enjoyed today's practice. Happy July 4th weekend. I hope that you're having a wonderful rest of your week. Thank you guys so much for joining. As always, it's been a pleasure to be able to share these practices with everyone. And once again, thank you guys so much. It's really been amazing. So Gail, have an amazing weekend. Madonna and Dawn, I hope that you all have a wonderful weekend this weekend. And please feel free to tune in if you'd like. I'm teaching, you know, classes throughout the weekend. So if you feel like you need a yoga class at some point, please feel free to stop on by. And yes, I will look forward to seeing all of you very, very soon, my friends. So as I usually close the class, I usually say these words. Happy 4th, everyone. Yes, thank you, Gail. I usually say the words, be well, be happy, namaste. So thank you guys so much. I hope that you have a wonderful weekend as well. Oh, absolutely. Thank you, Anton. Wonderful. So thank you guys so much. And be well, guys. Please feel free to check in if you like, and I'll be here. So if you have any questions, let me know. And I'll look forward to seeing you all very, very soon. Namaste, yogis. Thank you, guys.